Good morning, and welcome to St. Mary's. This morning's Mass celebrates the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Our celebrant this morning will be Father Matt, and we ask that you please turn off all cell phones and any electronic devices during the Mass, and please stand and join us in our opening hymn, Immaculate Mary.
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now in heaven with Jesus our King. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave, Ave Maria. In heaven the blessed your glory proclaims. On earth we, your children, invoke your fair name. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave, Ave Maria.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord of mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul, into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers of her glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Chronicles. David assembled all Israel in Jerusalem to bring the ark of the Lord to the place that he had prepared for it. David also called together the sons of Aaron and the Levites. The Levites bore the ark of God on their shoulders with poles, as Moses had ordained according to the word of the Lord. David commanded the chiefs of the Levites to appoint their kinsmen as chanters, to play on musical instruments, harps, lyres, and cymbals, to make a loud sound of rejoicing. They brought in the Ark of God and set it within the tent which David had pitched for it. Then they offered up burnt offerings and peace offerings to God. When David had finished offering up the burnt offerings and peace offerings, he blessed the people in the name of the Lord. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, when that which is mortal, clothes itself with immortality, then the word that is written shall come about. Death is swallowed up in a victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin. In the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While Jesus was speaking, a woman from the crowd called out and said to him, "Blessed is the womb that carried you and the breasts at which you nursed." He replied, "Rather, blessed are those who hear the word of God and observe it." The Gospel of the Lord. Today's great feast of the Assumption brings us, in particular in our first reading, in an encounter with what the church fathers instinctively saw, that there is an intimate connection between the Ark of the Covenant and Our Lady. Remember the Ark, right? Remember Raiders of the Lost Ark. It's a good visual. It's actually pretty accurate. It's just a wooden box with gold all over it. And in the box were held the remnants of the stone tablets that Moses brought down from the mountain. Some of the manna that the Israelites had in the desert, and the staff that Aaron used to strike the Nile to blood that he famously threw down and it turned to a snake. It was the holiest thing in all of Israel, and it contained the holiest things of Israel. It was set aside as special, at first in the meeting tent, and then later in the hill country outside Jerusalem. This is what this first reading is about. The Israelites have settled the land David has conquered. He's now entering into Jerusalem, the city of David. And he's sending for the ark. Bring the ark here. This is where God will establish his presence now. You see how the ark itself becomes the home, if you will, of the identity of the people of Israel. So too Our Lady, containing within herself not just fragments and museum pieces, but precisely the promises that those things imply, the very fulfillment of them, Christ himself. She is the new Ark of the Covenant, because in her very body, she brought forth what those things merely symbolized. The law and the prophets, the manna, and the authority of God, all present in Christ, who of course was first present in her. Where did David go to bring the Ark of the Covenant to Jerusalem? To the hill country of Judea, that's where it was being kept. Where did Mary hasten when she found she was pregnant? To the hill country of Judea, bringing the ark full circle. David even dances in front of the ark as a show of homage. Who danced when Mary showed up at Elizabeth's but John, the last great Old Testament prophet and the first great New Testament prophet? You see this beautiful symmetry at play. Now, we just had Mother's Day a little while ago in May, and we have a saccharine kind of view of motherhood sometimes. And it's fine. We get tender about our moms. It's good. It's good. But a mother's love is many things. But it's also supremely fierce, isn't it? It's more real than gravity. It's harder than concrete. History is full of examples of women doing extraordinary things for their children, extraordinary feats of bravery, even strength. We've all heard the stories of women lifting impossible amounts of weight to protect their children. Mistreat someone's child, you'll hear from that mother. A mother's love is fierce. Now, we're always filled with like cute images of baby tigers falling all over their mother or something. That's fine. That's cute. It's nice for Mother's Day. Makes for a nice little card. But mothers and motherhood are serious business. Mary is a mother in the fullest sense. What else did the Israelites use the ark for? It was a weapon. They brought it into battle. They marched around Jericho with the ark in front of them. Mary is our protector and our defender, and that is not a saccharine notion. She is fierce as any mother born, and she's ours. Where do we go but to her? And she's so special, and she's so important, and she's so necessary in the spiritual life that God himself, his only perfect creation, by the way, Mary. Everything else suffered from the fall except Mary. As the poet said, Mary is our tainted nature's solitary boast. Mary, Our Lady. So special, so perfect, that he preserved her from the corruption of the grave. by assuming her bodily and soul into heaven, following the path her son won for us. And from there, she is our defender, our protector, our warrior, as one theologian calls her. Yes, she's a queen, but she's a warrior queen. Fulton Sheen said, "The repetition of the rosary is like the staccato of a machine gun, just as powerful, even more so." And so we do well to always go back to our mother. When we're children, what do? We skin our knee and we run to mom. As adults, we take those metaphysical skinning knees and difficult mental problems in our lives. What else should we do? Do the same thing. Run to your mother. This image of Our Lady is an image of the Assumption. I kind of think of us as the unofficial Our Lady of the Assumption parish. I don't know why we're another St. Mary's. There's a lot of St. Mary's around here. Too many. There's too many St. Mary's. She has so many great titles. I don't know why we didn't use more. So many people will come to this church thinking they're going to Mansfield or Franklin or wherever and make me nervous because I didn't think I had a funeral today or I don't have a wedding today. Why are you here? Sometimes it is the undertaker that will show up. That really makes me nervous. It's like, no, you got to go across town. But that's the image of Our Lady being assumed. Some of you in the seats can see there's a little white box beneath her feet that represents the sarcophagus. She's being lifted from the grave, surrounded by angels, and the doves are, of course, the Holy Spirit. So I think of this feast as our unofficial feast, the parish feast, Our Lady of the Assumption. So friends, as we celebrate this great feast of Our Lady, it's a good and beautiful thing to have a Marian devotion. It's a good and beautiful thing to pray the rosary, any number of other Marian devotions. But don't do it in a saccharine, sweet, over-pietized kind of way. She's not in stained glass. She's in heaven, where she is mothering over us. With all that that means, mercy, tenderness, compassion, and love, but also a fierce protection and love that wants and demands good and great things for her children, me and you. So friends, never fail to run to your mother. Friends, let us stand and proudly profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate with the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Confident that God hears the prayers of his people, we turn to him now with all of our needs and intentions.
For the church on earth, may we, through the intercession of Mary, our mother, continue to grow in faith, hope, and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are hungry for community and friendship, may the Lord provide for them encouraging relationships of love and care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God to continue to watch over all police and military and essential personnel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may they know the joy of the resurrection as they see God's face in glory, especially Joyce Picard, members of the Mass Intention Guild, and all our beloved deceased. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Nicole Dalton, for whom our sanctuary candle is lit this week, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those needs best spoken in the silence of our hearts. For those needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the people of St. Mary's, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we turn to you with these our prayers. We unite them to the prayers of the blessed and ever-glorious Virgin Mary, and speak them in the name of her Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is Mary's Song.
Soul doth glory in your love, O Lord. My soul doth glory in your love, O Lord. For you gazed on your servant with compassion, and you reached out and took me by the hand. Great are you, God, and holy is your name. Your mercy reaches to the end of time. Ah, the lowly you raise to the heavens, and the proud-hearted have no faith in you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
Sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
May this oblation, our tribute of homage, rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts, aflame with the fire of love, constantly long for you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your church's coming to perfection, and a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Hosanna in the highest.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church in recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Yes,
let's offer each other a sign of peace. God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is Hail Mary, Gentle Woman.
Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father, you were chosen for the Son, you were chosen. Love, teach us wisdom.
next hymn is Miracle of Grace.
Your graces still prevail, and we become the love that we receive. Bread of life, bread of life. Those who eat this bread shall live and never die. Your presence in this holy sacrifice, bread of life. Unworthy though we are, you feed the hungry heart with bread come down from heaven above. And like a grain of wheat, we fall down at your feet, dying here with you. Oh, let us rise. Bread of life, bread of life. Those who eat this bread shall live and never die. Bread of life, bread of life. Your true presence in this holy sacrifice, bread of life. Your faithfulness revealed in this covenant you've sealed with your very body and your blood. Come claim your bride again with love that cannot end. For what God joins, no one can divide. Bread of life, bread of life. Those who eat this bread shall live and never die. Bread of life, bread of life. Your true presence in this holy sacrifice, bread of love, bread of
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Amen. A few announcements. We're in need of religious education teachers at all events, at all levels. Please call the rectory if you're able to volunteer. Please also call to register incoming first graders. There's a rosary circle next Saturday, the 21st, at 3 p.m. Details are in the bulletin. The next Bible study is entitled Follow Me, Meeting Jesus in the Gospel of John. Registration deadline of the 23rd, August the 23rd. And there's a wine and cheese social after the 4 o'clock Mass on Saturday, the 28th. Also, I'm happy to announce publicly that the next pastor of St. Mary's is Father Kevin Hickey. He is ordained in 2014. And he's a delayed vocation, as they say. He's an older gentleman, was in the work world for a number of years. He went to St. Pope John the 23rd Seminary in Weston. He was first assigned locally here. He was in Norfolk and Medway, so some of you may know him. And more recently, he's been doing quite a bit of hospital chaplaincy work. And this is his first parish as pastor. I don't know him, to be honest with you. We have friends in common, but I really don't know him. But I hear great things, and he's very excited to come here. And my first words to him were, congratulations, you're going to love it. This is a great parish, this is a great town, and that is to your credit. So if you are half as cooperative and half as warm and welcoming to him as you've been to me, this is going to be a great success. It's going to be a great success. So keep him in your prayers. Pray for him, pray for me, pray for Brockton, pray for everybody, okay? So, keep Father Kevin in your prayers, and he looks forward to hitting the ground running here in September. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn is Sing with All the Saints in Glory.
Sing with all the saints in glory, sing the resurrection song. Death and sorrow, earth's dark story, to the former days belong. All around the clouds are breaking, soon the storms of time shall cease. In God's likeness, people waking, know the everlasting peace.
Have a good Sunday.